And we welcome you back. Do you sleep with a nightlight, or do you like it so dark when you sleep that you can't see anything? Well, there is a new study that looked at the slightest bit of light during sleep hours and how it affected some participants' health. We welcome back to our studio our sleep expert, Dr. Joseph Ogile from the Clayton Sleep Institute. Good morning.
Good morning.
Did you sleep well?
I slept great.
I did too. All right, we're talking about light. I, for one, have to have at least a little bit of ambient light so I don't trip over a dog when I'm getting up in the middle of the night. But this new study said even the slightest bit of light can affect our overall health.
There is the possibility. It's a wonderful study done in Chicago by our colleague, Dr. Phyllis Z. They studied 20 people. Young people, by the way, and they had them in dark, all 20 for one night, and then they split the group, 10 and 10, dark, and then a little bit of ambient light, kind of like a cloudy day. Our news report for tomorrow, we're going to have clouds, sort of that kind of day. And what the study found, which is what you're getting at, is that in that group that had the cloudy day light in their room, they had increased insulin resistance, increased heart rate, and their heart rate variability was less, suggesting that their we call their sympathetic and parasympathetic tone was altered. So that could put you more at risk for things like diabetes and heart problems.
Wow. So were they able to go on this cloudy part? Were they able to actually get into that deep REM sleep?
They did get some, but not as much. So it did alter their sleep staging. And they did a great job of monitoring that. So one of the conclusions from the study is for most of us, we should try to have a darkened room. There's ways to do that. You can still meet your goals of not tripping over the dog, by the way, Randy, which I'm in favor of you not doing that.
Yeah, that'd be bad.
So because of LED lighting now, you could choose low-level red or brownish light, which is not as disruptive to sleep, but will give you enough light to see around.
Oh, so electronic devices, we've talked about that, and different color light bulbs like brownish or red, as you mentioned. What about a sleep mask, one of those deals?
So darkening your room. So sleep masks are great. You'll still have trouble with the dogs, but
I'll take it off when I get out of bed.
Sleep mask, darkening your room with curtains or shades are also helpful. And, of course, getting rid of as much ambient light as you can.
All right, daylight saving time is changing the light, the sunset, the sunrise, all that business. How does that affect our sleep? Because we're a good week in now.
We're a week in. Things should be getting better. As we've talked about in the past, those first few days, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, after the change, higher rates for this spring forward of things like heart attack and stroke and increased car accidents. So there does appear to be a move to not have this change happening.
Right, lawmakers are looking at it.
They've voted it through the Senate. There's no indication yet from the House or the executive branch of what they're going to do, but a bill has passed through the Senate to stop time changes in 2023.
I think most people kind of want that.
I think that would be, we've probably outlived its usefulness at this point.
He's the doctor. He knows. Thank you so much for coming in. If you'd like to reach out to the folks at Clayton Sleep Institute, Dr. Ogile and his colleagues, we will link you to their website on our website as well as our Fox 2 mobile app. Thanks, Doc.
Thank you.
Sleep well.
Thank you.
John, you awake?